Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to start the third story, that is the midnight visitor of class 10th. Let's directly start the story. This story is about a secret agent and our expectations from the appearance of a secret agent. And actually, what happens in the story? Let's start. Possible, our first character, did not fit any description of a secret agent Fowler had ever read. Following him down the musty corridor of the gloomy French hotel where Possible had a room, Fowler felt let down. It was a small room on the sixth and top floor and secretly a setting for a romantic adventure. We all are very much familiar that the life of the secret agents or detectives is full of adventure, is full of risk. An adventure is also no activity where there is risk, where there is unexpected things happens. So Possible is the name of the secret agent and Fowler is a writer and he has come to meet Possible because he is very much fascinated towards the adventurous things. But the moment he saw Possible, he was disappointed because Possible was not looking as fit, smart as a secret agent should be according to the Fowler view, point of view. Possible was for one thing fat, very fat. And then there was his accent. See, in the first paragraph, the writer has described where Fowler met Possible. It was the a building of sixth floor and in the top floor he is meeting with Possible, meaning he is going to meet him. And he is, Possible is fat, actually very fat. And then there was his accent and his accent was also not very smart as it should be of detectives. As far as Fowler is concerned, though he spoke French and German passed by, he had never altogether lost the American accent he had brought to Paris from Boston 20 years ago. Meaning in his accent, there is a touch of he was capable to speak French, German, American, and you all are very much familiar that accent also change. People accent also change as far as their country and language is concerned. You are disappointed, Possible said wisely over his shoulder. You were told that I was a secret agent, a spy, dealing in espionage and danger. Possible himself noticed the disappointment he saw in the face of Fowler after meeting him. And he said, definitely you are feeling disappointed because you knew that I was a spy and I was dealing with dangerous things. But you must be disappointed to see me as I am fat enough. My accent is also not very smart as far as detectives are concerned. You wish to meet me because you are a writer, young and romantic. You envisioned mysterious figures in the night, the crack of pistol, drugs in the wine. So he said, I know you had come to meet me because you had the idea I am a detective and you must be meeting me in absolutely romantic situations where wine is there, pistol is there, and you must be expecting very high from me. And you are a young, energetic writer. That's why you must have come to get some ideas. Instead, you have spent a dull evening in a French music hall with a sloppy, fat man who, instead of having messages slipped into his hand by dark-eyed beauties, gets only a prosaic telephone call, making an appointment in his room. He said, you must be thinking that there should be drug, wine, there should be pistols, and I must be getting messages from beautiful ladies, because generally the detectives have their beautiful ladies are also they are appointing to give them messages. But he said, you must be disappointed that I got my message with a prosaic, meaning very boring, telephonic appointment, telephone call conversation. You have been bored. Osabel guessed it. He said, you must be feeling bored. The fat man chuckled, meaning started smiling, laughing to himself, as he unlocked the door of his room and stood aside to let his frustrated guest enter. As I have already told you, Osabel is supposed to spend that night on the sixth floor of a building. Osabel and Fowler both were entering into that room. So meanwhile on the way, Osabel was having this conversation with Fowler. Then he opened the door of that room and he kept aside so that his guest Fowler should enter first. You are disillusioned, Osabel told him. But take cheer, my young friend. Now Osabel again said that you must feeling disappointed. You had some high expectations from me, but it did not turn right. But no problem, cheer up. Presently you will see a paper, a quite important paper for which several men and women have risked their lives. Come to me. Someday soon, that paper may well affect the course of history. In that thought, is drama, is there not? He said, but come. Today I am going to talk about and I am going to get one important paper. And that important paper is going to change the entire history of that area. So, and many men and women are after that paper. So now that touch of mystery, the touch of adventure is going to enter in our story. As he spoke, Osabel closed the door behind him. Then he switched on the light. And as the light came on, Fowler had his first enthusiastic thrill of the day. For halfway across the room, a small automatic pistol in his hand stood a man. Fowler was telling all these things while entering the room. When he entered into room, switched on the light. But suddenly what Fowler noticed, there was one man was standing with pistol. And right now he said he had some very important piece of paper that's going to change the entire history of that area. So it means because of that paper, this man had entered into his room. Now Fowler get excited. Now he felt good that this was the excitement he wanted to meet. And now with the presence of the man with the pistol, he was able to meet that excitement. Osabel blinked a few times, meaning it was not very unexpected for Osabel. So he also blinked. Max, he whizzed. You gave me quite a start. Start meaning you gave me a shock. I thought you were in Berlin. What are you doing here in my room? Now, Osabel said, oh, Max, meaning he knew that person who was there ready with pistol. He said, okay, you are there, but I was not expecting you. I thought you were in Berlin. So this is the beginning of the story, my dear students. This link will help you to understand it. We will meet very soon again in the next video. Thank you.